Since starting this YouTube channel, I've had several people ask me offline, because many people don't comment on my comments, which I really wish you would, what is the most difficult thing about creating a YouTube channel? And I would have to say there's several things that have been difficult for me. The very first thing was coming up with a name. The very first name that I came up with, nobody seemed to actually like. And so now this channel is called Russ is Right. Now people say it doesn't make any sense. You're not talking about anything that you're right. Well, I'm always right. I told you guys that, except for when I'm wrong, right? But no, you have to come up with some type of name. So that's the name I came up with. Whether it's the right name or not, we'll see. The second thing I think that is the most difficult thing is coming up with a topic that people would be interested in watching. Now, you might know that I started a secondary channel with my friend Stacy, and that's called Jive Guys. So if you haven't seen that before, I'll put a link on the description below so that you can actually find a Jive Guys channel. It's more of a comedy channel, really, than anything. But we have an opportunity to talk to each other, and you guys get to hear that too. And we have some pretty interesting discussions. And we've had these types of discussions for many years, but we never put anything on video. So I felt that that would be an interesting thing. So we still run into problems trying to find good, interesting topics to do. But that's not the only problems, I think. Things that I've learned over time since doing this video venture for me is there's a certain amount of acting you have to do. Now, it's not like I act in front of you guys, but you don't usually respond the same way on camera than you do in person. And I think that's something that you have to get over. Another thing that I found that is difficult to do is if you're out in public and people are watching you record yourself, that's a hard thing to do. That takes a little bit of guts, so to speak, because you're kind of self-conscious about it. But after time, I think that kind of goes away. I could at this point now just go in front of anybody and just run this camera and start talking. I know they're looking at me. I know that they're watching me. They're kind of like, what's this guy doing? But after a while, you just don't seem to care. You just do it. Now, I haven't gotten brave enough to go do some of the things that some of the other YouTubers do. You know, they'll go to restaurants unannounced and they'll start recording and start eating and put a camera up on their table. I haven't done that yet. I don't know if I will or I won't, but I have an interest to see, find out if I could do it, just to see if I have the guts to do that. But that takes a little bit of nerve to be able to do, or just walking into an establishment and just start talking by yourself. That takes a little bit of guts, right? It's not an easy thing to do. So it's not normal stuff that we do on a daily basis. So it's learned behavior, so to speak. But I think in time, you do get over that. If you are also looking to start a YouTube channel or thinking about starting a YouTube channel after watching mine, let me encourage you to do it. It's not a difficult thing to do. If you have a camera that can take video, you've got most of the equipment right there. You'll need a tripod, maybe a microphone. Right now I'm using a studio mic, but a lavalier microphone that clips onto your shirt, something like that, is probably a better way to go. I mentioned that there's several different devices out there. You can buy the Rode Video Smart Lav, I think it's called. The Rode Smart Lav Plus, I believe. $70, $79, something like that. And that'll plug directly into your phone and record the audio tracks that way. Then you sync it up with the visuals that you record with your camera. Now that's typically better than using the built-in microphone in your camera. I have a couple videos, if you look back in some of the old Russ is Right videos, you'll see me talking a little bit about that, and you'll hear the difference between them too. Audio makes a big difference. If you don't do good audio and you have good visuals, people will still tune out simply because it's kind of hard to watch that video when the sound is terrible. So you have a camera, you might need to buy a microphone. If you have a tripod, that's basically really all you really need. You don't need this fancy green screen thing that I'm doing behind here. It's nice if you have it. You know, you can add those things. Video editing, it's not difficult to buy something like Adobe Premiere Elements, which is about maybe $80, $70, $80. You can use that to edit your videos. Currently, right now, I'm using the Adobe Final Cut Pro 10 program, which is about a $300 program. But as you get better and better at it, you want to get better edits in there, and maybe you'll invest a little bit in that. You will need a fairly decent computer, all right? In terms of editing, it does take a little bit of power for your computer to run. You will need some hard drive space because these videos are very large, and it's going to take some time to upload to YouTube as well. So there's an investment in time as well. But in terms of sheer dollars, if you have a camera that does video, you know, half the battle is there already. All you have to do is just get up and do it. Find a topic that you are passionate about, something that you have an interest in, that you think that the audience will be interested in hearing and watching, and then just run it. And you'll make mistakes. I've made a lot of mistakes already from my beginning videos, but as I've gotten over time, I've gotten better at it. So just want to encourage you guys, if you're interested in creating your own channel, go ahead and do it. It's not a difficult thing. Hey, if you like these videos, go ahead and hit the like button and hit the little subscribe button too, because that'll keep it going for you with me, and hit the little bell icon because that'll tell you when new videos happen via email. YouTube automatically sends you an email. Oh, let me address one more thing too. People have said, does it cost me anything to subscribe? And the answer is no, there is no cost to subscribe on YouTube, all right? What the subscriptions basically do is it gives the creator an indication of how many people are interested in his videos. And it also gives them the ability to get the channel monetized. Monetization is when advertisers start taking notice of a channel and start advertising on it. So it does financially help the creator down the road. Now, it's gonna be a long time for me, but again, every little bit helps. So I do appreciate it when you hit that little subscribe button. And not only subscribing, you have to watch the videos, because it is important for YouTube to find out how many people are really watching our videos. So watch the videos and share it with your friends. Talk to you guys next time.